If there was any tragedy in history that would top the world wars, 9/11 or Hindenburg, it would be a very fatal disease called the coronavirus. People have called these times challenging. They've called them unprecedented and even uncertain. To me, these times are really just dangerous and deadly. It all started earlier this year, when the coronavirus jumped from country to country by the minute, turning the number of cases from tens to hundreds to thousands. The situation was so severe that the World Health Organization had no choice but to declare it a pandemic. And shortly afterwards, the cases jumped to millions by the day. The pandemic led to the most grim moments in recent history. The shocking cancellations of the greatest annual events of all time, TV content made in people's houses, sports suspended indefinitely, WrestleMania moved to the performance center, and worst of all, being ordered by the government to stay at home at all times, no matter the cost. During the pandemic, people had started taking compassion too seriously by sending heartwarming messages about not giving up hope. Soon, there had been ads about compassion and everything coronavirus related. And it kept on going and going as it still is to this very day.
I can't take it anymore!
And it sickens me, because the idea of trying to stop the spread of the coronavirus by the so-called powers of positivity and unity is clearly not enough. The cases still skyrocket anyway. Even with Joe Biden now in office, the lockdowns and restrictions will still continue beyond the new year. Next thing you know, we will have to wear gas masks and all essential shops will shut down. And don't get me started on those vaccines. They are bound to have side effects like increased risk of cancer or bleeding in the eyes. So no matter how people obey anti-coronavirus orders, or how much compassion we desperately need, the dangerous and deadly times will not go away for a very long time. We are still forced to get used to it. We have no choice, because there is no choice. Have an unhappy new year.